It's done. Okay, fine. First question is in front of you. An aqueous solution of copper 2 sulfate was made by adding excess copper 2 oxide to dilute sulfuric acid. The mixture was heated, stirred, and then filtered. Dilute sulfuric acid you have, copper oxide you have. When it filtered, you can see the copper sulfate solution formed. Question is, what was the pH of the acid before adding the copper 2 oxide and the solution after filtration? Question is very easy. You have to tell the pH before adding and after adding. So don't think that question will be very straightforward. Okay, tell me the pH of acetic acid, tell me the pH of tartaric acid, whether it's a less than 7, more than 7. It is not like that. You will have questions like this where you are mixing two things and then you have to think about the pH values. So questions will be little different in this. Shouldn't have mentioned it with an acid. Should not have mentioned what? It's an acid. Ha, yes, you are right. But fine, no problem. You see what is the pH before adding copper oxide, pH before adding this. What is the answer? Okay, fine. Everyone has voted. Good. I hope that this time I'm going to get. Oh, only 25. More than 50% students have marked it wrong. My dear students, when you put the copper oxide plus H2SO4, double displacement reaction, copper sulfate will form CuSO4. CuSO4 is a neutral salt. That's why pH will be 7 after the reaction. And since the previous you have the H2SO4, that H2SO4 is acidic, so pH was less than 7. If anyone has any doubt, please ask, then I'll go to question and explain. No. See, copper sulfate, sir, can you show the question once? Okay, fine. Okay, see. This was the question. So the thing which is you are getting is the copper sulfate after the reaction. After the reaction, you are getting copper sulfate. Okay. So we generally don't say that copper sulfate is acidic. We say it's a neutral only, copper 2 sulfate. You know what you are getting with the pH of the acid before adding copper 2 oxide and solution after filtration. This filtrate is nothing but copper sulfate. But it's added in excess. Since copper oxide is basic salt, right? Yes, copper oxide is basic, no doubt. Copper oxide is basic. Yes, it is excess. Okay, you are saying that the first solution, you are saying that dilute sulfuric acid is in excess. So you thought that it is less than 7. Yes? No. See, you have to think like that. Everything got dissolved. Now what happens? You have a copper sulfate only. Okay, what happens? CuO plus H2SO4 gives you CuSO4 plus water. It is nothing but a kind of a neutralization reaction, and this is the salt produced. Okay, yes, you can say that there are chances, but still it is a neutral salt. Copper sulfate which you are going to get is a neutral one. Okay, but now I get it. But sir, isn't H2SO4 is a strong acid? The salt formed should be acidic. Okay, see, copper 2 sulfate, generally we say it is nothing but what I want to tell you. Copper plus 2 is there and sulfate 2 minus is there. If you go like that, there is no hydrolysis of copper 2 plus. Okay, so relatively they are the same only. Your concept is right that copper sulfate is, but you can also say that copper hydroxide is not that weak. Okay, copper hydroxide is weak only. I'm not saying like it is strong base, but it is comparatively, it is also a good base. Okay, and with the sulfate it forms a neutral salt. So pH of solution after filtration, you have a copper sulfate. So copper sulfate is neutral in nature. Okay, now you can also think like that. So H2SO4 is there and you filtered it and you have mixed the full thing. So whatever you have is nothing but a copper sulfate. Okay, I think 1 minute. I'm not hearing any voice. Just a minute. Maybe 1 minute, 1 minute, students. I'm not able to hear any of your audio. Just now you can speak. Okay, if anyone has any doubt, please ask. Earlier I was not able to hear your voice. Okay, so this is the answer. Answer is C. Understood? Less than 7, then copper sulfate equals to 7. Any doubts, students? Okay, we will have more this type of question, don't worry. So now we are moving to the leaderboard. Okay, Umesh is the fastest. Umesh, you have not written your school name, so I don't know whether you are my student or from which school you are. Please. Okay, you should write. The second question, an alloy contains copper and zinc. Okay, read the question carefully. It is also 1 hour 30 seconds. Read the question carefully. Don't think that there is no numerical means you can answer it very easily. An alloy contains copper and zinc. Some of the zinc have become oxidized to zinc oxide. What is the result of adding excess of dilute sulfuric acid to the alloy? You have to think. Please mute your mic. Okay. An alloy contains copper and zinc. You know that copper and zinc alloy, and some zinc is oxidized in ZnOH. Okay. Okay. Okay, time's up. Oh, 22 students have answered it right. Let's see this question again, how to answer this. So, if you see the question number 2, okay, so then I'm moving to the next question. 1 minute, students. One. Okay, so question number 2 is some alloy contains copper and zinc. Very good question. Alloy contains copper and zinc. Okay, so you have a copper and zinc, but zinc is in the oxide form. Some of the zinc has become oxidized to ZnO. The result in adding excess of dilute sulfuric acid to the alloy. Now what you do, you put the H2SO4, dilute sulfuric acid. Okay. In dilute sulfuric acid, when you add and zinc oxide, so what happens? In the previous question also, someone asked, sir, it should be acidic. There, you know, when you take a dilute sulfuric acid for the preparation, there is a very, it is a very less acidic. Okay, that one student asked, that is very good question, sir. Copper sulfate is formed from strong acid and weak base. Yes, generally it should be. Whenever salt is from the strong acid, weak base, it should be the acidic in nature. So now some of the zinc has become oxidized to ZnO. What is the result of adding an excess dilute acid to the alloy? Excess when you add, now it is very important question. You know ZnSO4 will form. ZnSO4. And copper will remain as it is. You know one fact that copper won't react with sulfuric acid. So copper won't react with acid. Why? Because copper is, tell me, who can answer? Why copper does not react with sulfuric acid? Because copper is, no, not less electronegative. Copper comes below hydrogen in electrochemical series. Do you remember I told you, please stop calling me a careless zombie? Do you remember on first day I told you one trick? Yes? Stop calling me a careless zombie. Instead is iron. how creator mercy, mercy is the mercury. Now this how is H. H copper is below hydrogen, it won't displace. So no reaction, copper will remain as it is. So pink brown solid remains, but your zinc oxide will get dissolved and the solution, colorless solution. Generally Zn plus 2 salts are colorless. Salts are colorless, always remember, colorless. Understood students? That's why answer is B. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. No doubts? Please write ND. Please write ND if no, you don't have any doubt. Okay. Moving to the next question. These are very, very good questions. So take your time and then answer. Okay. Moving to the next question, that is, first we'll see the leaderboard. And leaderboard says that Aniket Gupta INR 10. Oh, Alisha is leading now. Fine. Moving to the next question. Please read the question. Please see the timing. Okay. Timing is very important in today's quiz. Which is not a typical property of acid? Definitely you will not have a 1 hour 30 seconds. A 1 minute 30 seconds. You will have only 55 seconds now. Which is not a typical property of an acid? Okay. 29 seconds left. Okay, which is not a typical property of an acid? Yes, students, fast. Why, Aniket? You must have not read the question properly. Okay, let's see how many of you are getting full marks in this. I hope that this time, oh, only 18 students. Students, what you are doing? You will make mistake like this. Okay, so next question is, okay, see, the next question is, this is the third one. Okay, we see third question, how to do. Which is not a typical property of acid? They react with alkalis producing water, no doubt. Pardon? They react with alkalis, this is right. They react with all metals producing hydrogen. Few minutes back I told you, it does not react with copper, it does not react with gold, it does not react with silver, it does not react with platinum. They react with carbonate producing carbon dioxide. Very, very important point. So acid, let's say H2SO4, reacting with copper carbonate, let's say CuCO3. When they react, there is a double displacement reaction. How to write double displacement? H plus SO4 2 minus, copper plus 2, CO3 2 minus. Double displacement means H will go with CO3, copper will go with sulfate. You will get CuSO4 plus H2O plus CO2. In last class also I told you, whenever H2CO3 it breaks into H2O and CO2, you will definitely get gas. This is also correct. They turn litmus paper red. This is also correct. So answer is B. Why you people made mistake in this? Yes, H2CO3 is unstable. Yes, that's why I have written here H2O and CO2. Aditya, do you have any doubt, Aditya? That's why it gives you carbon dioxide gas. Yes, sir, same thing. Okay, means do you have any doubt? Anyone? No doubts? Very good. You can ask me anytime whenever you have doubt, because next question may be related to this concept. Okay, first we'll see the leaderboard. And now who is leading? Who is Booty Mac Boat Face? Who is this? Please write your name. Okay, Abhipsha is leading. Very good, Abhipsha. Fine, moving to the next question. Please read the question, see the time, and see the options properly. Very good question is in front of you. The oxide of element X was added to an acid. It reacts to form a salt and water. Which is the pH of the acid? What is the pH of the acid before the reaction? And what type of element is X? Okay. So what is the type of element X? So you are adding some oxide from top, that is element X, and you have acid inside that. You have acid also. When you put acid in that, you are getting something. Thank you, Surya. So tell me, what is the answer for this question? Why, Aditya, every time you say, oh no. Okay. I hope this time I will get a good graph. Okay, this time is good. 42 students have marked it right. Very good, students. That is a definitely, because salt is forming, must be metallic oxide. Because one side you have acid. Acid is only forming salt with base. Base must be metallic oxide. Metallic oxides are always basic in nature. Metallic oxides are basic, so you will get the salt. And the second option was, what was the pH? It is less than 7. Any doubt? Oh, you are in this one of the 7. Oh my god. No doubts? Very good. Moving to the, okay, first we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, I think Purva is leading now. No, still Abhipsha. Very good, Abhipsha. Okay, next question. Please read the question carefully. An aqueous solution of organic compound methylamine has pH greater than 7. Okay, which statement about methylamine is correct? It neutralizes an aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide. It reacts with copper carbonate to give carbon dioxide. It reacts with hydrochloric acid to form salt. It turns blue litmus red. Very easy question this time. I hope this time all of you are going to get. Okay. Fine, it times up. Okay, 38 students have marked it right. Very good, students. The C option was the only correct option. Okay, tell me if anyone has any doubt. Please ask. Then ask that the C option was just acid-base reaction. It neutralizes with acid. So why you people have made the mistake? Please let me know if you have any good doubt. There may be someone has thought of some exception, and you can tell me that exception. Maybe the answer of 38 students are wrong in that case. But you have to tell me, sir, what is the formula of compound? What is the formula of compound? What they have given? Okay, let me see the question. The compound they gave is, just a minute. Compound methyl amine. Okay, you know what is the amine? Amine is this. Amine is any compound which has a NH2 group. NH2 group, okay, this is known as amine. Alkyl amine. What you call it as? Alkyl amine. So they said the methyl means R is nothing but CH3, one carbon. So compound name is, the compound is CH3NH2. This is the methyl amine. Any other doubt, please ask. Any doubt? Momita? Okay, fine. So, you know, amines are base. Okay, one thing I want to ask you, since your friend has asked one good question, what is the formula? If I ask you, who can answer which type of base is this? Which type of base? Tell me. Who can answer? No, weak is fine. There are three types of acid and bases. Which type of base is this? Okay, I'll tell you, there are three types of bases. What is that? Arrhenius base, Bronsted and Lowry base, and Lewis base. Bronsted and Lowry, Lewis and Arrhenius. Which base is this? Who can answer? Okay, it is a mixed answers I am getting. Okay, so I'll write here Bronsted, I'll write here Arrhenius, I'll write here, I'll write here Lewis. You know the answer of this question is? What is the answer of this? You know, Arrhenius base are those bases which gives OH minus. Which gives OH minus. Can it give OH minus? Can it give OH minus? It is not having O at all. It is not having O. So it is not Arrhenius base. Can it be a Bronsted base? Bronsted means proton. From Bronsted base means proton acceptor. Can it accept proton? Yes, it can accept proton. How? NH3, if I write like this, CH3NH3 plus proton will give you ammonium. CH3NH4 plus. It is a proton acceptor. It is a Bronsted and Lowry. Can it be a Lewis base also? It is also a Lewis base. Because Lewis base is something that is lone pair donor. Something which has a lone pair. That is a Lewis base. Is it having lone pair? Is it having lone pair? Nitrogen? Yes, nitrogen is having lone pair. If you draw the nitrogen amine structure, it is like this. And one lone pair is there. Because there are 8 electrons must be there in nitrogen. One, I'll write here like this. I'll write like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These 8 electrons are there. So it has a lone pair. So it is both type of base. Please remember this. Very important point. Any doubt? No? Okay, good. So moving to the next one. First we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, let's see who is leading. Oh, Abhipsha, Prishim, Surya, very good students. Surya was the fastest, very good. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Be ready for that. Some reaction of substance R as shown in the diagram. Substance R reacts with magnesium, sodium carbonate, copper oxide. One give hydrogen, one give carbon dioxide, one give copper 2 sulfate respectively. What type of substance R is? What type of substance R is? You have to think. Thank you, students. Okay, tell me. Easy? Yes, very easy. I think most of you have answered. Those who have not answered, please answer it fast. Hydrogen gas is released with magnesium. Carbonate gives CO2. Oxide gives sulfate. What type of substance R is? Okay, still few of you have not answered. Please answer it fast. Thank you, Aditya. Okay, fine. So, I think all of you got the answer. Yes. Let's see, this time I'm expecting a long bar on a correct answer. Okay, let's see. Okay, answer is A. Very good, students. Answer is A because that was acid. Two questions we have already discussed like this. Whenever there is acid with the copper oxide, it forms a sulfate ion. Acid gives hydrogen gas with metal. Understood? Any doubt in this? Acid gives hydrogen gas with metal. And what was the second option? I forgot. What was that? What was that second option? Acid with base. Yes. Okay. Carbonic. That will give CO2. Whenever there is a carbonate with acid, it gives CO2. Few minutes back we discussed. Very good, students. But still I didn't get 100% result. Okay, now here, who is leading now? Oh, Surya was still the fastest one. Good, Surya. But see now what is there on your plate. So next is substance K react with sodium carbonate. Substance K reacts with sodium carbonate. With sodium carbonate to form a gas. The gas turns lime water milky. What is the substance K which possesses take place in the reaction? And which process takes place in the reaction? 33 I have already answered. Which type of reaction? Okay, they have not confused you much. They have given you options like combustion and neutralization. Yes, so combustion is something where you get some gas. You all know that which gas is released in the combustion, and that causes the greenhouse effect also. That causes greenhouse effect. So neutralization you all know. Okay, fine. So answer of this question is, okay, those who have not answered, please answer it fast. Next few questions will be based on the salts. I am again telling, next few questions will be based on the salts. So you need to think too much in those questions. Okay, so answer for this question is, again a mixed answer. Why students, why? 27 students have marked it wrong, 32 right. Why? The question was very easy. The question they have asked is, combustion reaction is giving CO2, that's correct. But neutralization was that process. HCl is reacting with any carbonate, give you CO2 gas. And that CO2 gas is giving lime water milky. And that reaction is nothing but a neutralization reaction. Any doubt? 27 students, did you understood this? Okay, fine. I'll show it. It was, I think, 7th question, right? Yes. So this was the question. They have given you sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, hydrochloric acid, HCl, gives you, then you have given lime water milky, that is definitely CO2 gas. Which reaction is taking place? You know, okay, very good question you can ask here. What is the nature of ethanols? What is the nature of ethanol? Is it acidic or basic? What is the nature of ethanol? Is it acidic or basic? Okay, alkali. Two have written alkali. Three have written alkali. Anyone else? Is it acidic, basic or neutral? You know, no one is answering now because not an acid nor base, it's a neutral. Very good, Aryan. It is not acidic. It is ethanol is this, CH3OH. It is having hydrogen, but it is not acidic. When you put the pH paper, when you put the litmus paper, there is no change in color in case of ethanol. It is a neutral only. Or we say very less acidic, means less acidic than water also. Water is slightly acidic. Water is slightly acidic, ethanol is even less acidic than water. Understood? So answer, it was not acidic, that's why you people have made the mistake. Hydrochloric acid will give you H2O plus CO2 plus NaCl. Thank you for asking this question, otherwise I would have not explained you this part. So those who have small doubt also please ask it. Don't keep your doubts with you. Otherwise, I would have skipped this part. Ethanol, I would have not told you ethanol is neutral in nature. Okay, fine. Can I move to next question? Would I move to next question? Tell me. Okay, fine. So, moving to the next one. That says, okay, but before that, just look at the leaderboards. Leaderboard says, okay, Prishim is next to Avipsha. Good. Fine, no problem. Just keep it up. Next question is, please read the question carefully and see the time. Okay. The result of test of solid X are shown. When there is a sodium hydroxide green precipitate form, when there is an acidified silver nitrate yellow precipitate form, what is the X? It is a simple question based on the salt. The result of the two tests of X are given. Okay. 30 students have answered, but you know 30 seconds are left with you now. It was just 60 seconds. So, aqueous sodium hydroxide added, green precipitate, silver, you know this, thank you Surya. This question you can think, we discussed it in chemical equation chapter also, somewhere I told you. Okay. Fine. So now we are going to see. Oh, that's a cool. So this time I got 14 correct answers only. Okay, this is a good graph. Okay, now see how to do this question. So question is, just a minute. Question is something, I think 8 question we have to discuss. Okay, question is very easy. The result of two tests X shown, aqueous sodium hydroxide added green precipitate form. I want to tell you all of you, you know green precipitates are generally for Fe2+. Fe2+ salts give green color. Generally Fe2+ salts are green in color. Okay, generally, okay fine, so green color. Now see, if you have a Fe2+ somewhere and if hydroxide reacts, you will get two hydroxide will react, you will get FeOH whole twice. So this is the reaction most likely to form and this is a green precipitate. Generally hydroxides of all the metal other than group 1, that last class also I told you, Halina ki rab se faryaad, other than those hydroxides, all hydroxides are precipitate. They generally form precipitate. Okay, so it is a green precipitate, PPT. So this is Fe2+. Acidified silver nitrate. You know acidified silver nitrate is AgNO3 and it is acidified means in presence of H+, but giving yellow precipitate with which salt? With which salt? You know, now there is a very very important part. Silver is going to form salt and we discussed in class in the chemical equation chapter with iodide, AgI, this is yellow in color. AgI is yellow in color. Okay, all those things we discussed. Do you remember this? This was the question I explained, if I remember it properly, I explained that in when we discussed photochemical reactions, or we discussed a black and white photography. Do you remember black and white photography? There I discussed this PbI2 and all those things. So AgI is formed. Now see which is the best possible option. D is the best possible option. Iron is Fe2+ iodide. Here it's a chloride. No, it will not form yellow. Copper 2 hydroxide is also not green in color. Iodide is right. But copper 2 hydroxide is not green in color. Copper 2 plus hydroxide is not green in color. Chloride is definitely wrong. So answer is D. Silver chloride is white in color. White in color. Any other doubt, students? No doubt? Could we move to next question? Yes. So there are 15 questions. Don't worry. We will be able to finish that. So first we will see the leaderboard. Okay, now this I think is a game changer question. Let's see how many of you have lost their positions and how many of you have improved also. Oh, good. Surya is leading. Very good, Surya. Okay, now be ready for the next question. Same type of question, but this time it's a little different. Solution containing substance X was tested. Test is given, result is given. Test is when we do the flame test. You know flame test, when you put the metal salt, when you put the metal salt and you just put in the flame and you see the color of a flame. That color of a flame is lilac color. Okay, fine. Acidified silver nitrate solution, yellow precipitate. Okay, now you have to think. Only 20 seconds, 24 seconds left. So be ready for that. Okay. 3 seconds. Fine. Oh my God. 24 students have done this right, but more than that, people have done this question wrong. Students, that was not very difficult question. It was again a easy kind of question for you. Just you need to understand that flame test. Why I gave this question? To tell you the flame test. There are few flame tests you need to remember. Okay, there are few metals. You say sodium. Sodium gives golden yellow color. Salt of sodium gives golden yellow color in flame. Potassium gives lilac color. Potassium gives lilac. Calcium gives brick red color in flame. Strontium is crimson red. Okay, this all you will learn later also. Barium is a very beautiful color, that is apple green. It looks very nice when you see the barium salt put in the flame, apple green. Okay, copper salts are generally bluish or greenish also sometimes we say. That's it. These are all important. Copper is also not that important, but these are very, very important. So lilac color means potassium and yellow PPT few minutes back we discussed iodine. So that answer is nothing but potassium iodide. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? Okay, lithium does not show color, my dear. Lithium does not show color in flame test. Any other doubt? All the iodide salts are yellow. No, please don't make this thing. All iodides are not yellow. AgI is yellow. That's it. Can you show the question? Okay, do you want me to show the question again? All? It's not all. Okay, fine. See this? Okay, they have given the yellow precipitate. Understood, they have given the yellow precipitate. So you are saying that how can we get to know that potassium iodide and potassium bromide? Okay, silver bromide is actually you can say like that, but see potassium iodide and bromide, which is actually a little pale yellow in color, pale yellow we say. Okay, so that is also a nice question that how can we judge that it is how is it a yellow color or means which yellow color it is forming? But you know AgBr is a little a pale yellow color, so you can also say that AgBr in that case. Okay, but since the color is pale yellow, I would go with the better option is this one, AgI. Understood? Students, actually it's a dark yellow. Yellow precipitate we say the AgI. Okay, and both are yellow only. So you could, I know that many of you have answered that AgI also. Okay, how many of you have answered AgBr? Sorry. How many of you have answered AgBr? The chrome yellow. Actually, it's a yellow, but you know the shades of yellow, it's all this thing is differing in the shades of yellow. That's the point. Understood? So, but your answer is not, I can't say it's a wrong, completely wrong, but whenever you say the iodides are completely yellow, otherwise we say the pale yellow in that case of AgBr. Understood, Anish? Anish, did you understand? Okay, moving to the next question. Okay, Surya is still leading and he was the fastest. Okay, moving to the next question. The white solid is insoluble in water. When it is added to hydrochloric acid, bubbles of the gas are formed. Adding aqueous ammonia to the solution formed gives a white precipitate. Adding excess aqueous ammonia causes the precipitate to re-dissolve. Now think about this. Okay. You have to think about this question. That's why I kept time as 1 minute 30 seconds. You have to think, you have to write, then only you can able to answer. You know, this is the one of the favorite questions of like competitive exams. In competitive exam, these type of questions are asked in inorganic chemistry. Okay, fine. Okay, Surya, okay, I think I might have messed up. Good. Thank you, Surya. Okay, so the true yellow, okay, fine. I think this time most of you are going to give wrong answer only. Let's see. I don't know about you people. You people say, oh, it is only 12. Only 12 students. Fine. We'll see how to do this question. Don't worry, don't worry. I'm here. So we'll see how to do this question. So question is very easy, you know. You have to think. You have to think what is happening. What is happening. So it's not always whenever you see the big question, then only you will that are only tough. These are also, this question is considered in tough questions only. White solid is insoluble in water. White solid, okay, fine. Let's find one information we got. Acid HCl bubbles given. Okay, it is most likely to be carbonate. Most likely to be carbonate. I'm not sure. I can just say it's most likely to be carbonate. Adding aqueous ammonia. Aqueous ammonia is nothing but NH4OH. Adding aqueous ammonia to the solution formed give a white precipitate. Oh my god. NH4OH gives white precipitate means, okay, we will see. Adding excess ammonia causes precipitate to redissolve. Now this gives a very important hint. Excess ammonia can be dissolved if it is a copper salt. Copper can dissolve in excess ammonia. If it is a zinc salt, it can also be dissolved in aqueous ammonia. Copper zinc can be dissolved in excess ammonia. Aluminium won't. Aluminium salt won't dissolve in excess ammonia. Calcium salt won't dissolve in excess ammonia. Ammonium salt won't dissolve in excess ammonia. So three options are gone. Ammonium gone, calcium gone, aluminium gone. Answer is this. By just the last statement. Copper and zinc salts are dissolved in excess ammonia due to complex formation. Complex are one type of salt you will learn in class 12. Due to complex formation, copper and zinc salts, even Pb also, even Pb, copper, zinc, Pb salts are soluble in aqueous ammonia. Okay, salts, or you can write redissolve. Okay, just a minute, students. I'll write here. Pb hydroxides, copper, zinc, and Pb hydroxides redissolve. Redissolve. That is a very, very important point. Okay? So answer is zinc carbonate. And zinc salt, I few minutes back I told you, zinc salts are white in nature. So zinc carbonate are white. It is white. A few minutes back I told you. Here that's why they have given white. Gas given carbonate. The students, did you understand this question? It is very, very important. Did you understood this? All of you? Yes? Any doubt? Calcium carbonate white. Calcium salts are generally white. Reaction with NH4OH. You want to know the reaction? You want to see the reaction? But it is not required, my dear, for you. It's not required for you. But still you want to see NH4OH, how it reacts. It react to form ZnOH whole 4. Complex will form 2 plus. Okay, ammonia complex, sorry. So, okay, 1 minute. Redissolves, excess of ammonia causes. Excess of ammonia they have written. So here not NH, it will be NH3. Okay, so NH3 will react and here you will get plus 4 charge. Some type of complex will form. That is a complex, you don't need that. Understood? If anyone has any doubt, please ask. No doubts? Zinc ammonia forms a complex, that is ZnNH4 2 plus, not 4 plus, it is 2 plus only. It is 2 plus. This type of complex is formed. I'll write, rewrite it. Zinc NH3 4 2 plus. This is the answer. Understood? Someone asked, some girl asked. Okay, fine. Okay, now we will see the leaderboard. Okay, this time we'll see who is leading. Okay, it seems like Alicia, sorry. Very good, Alicia. Okay, next question. Which two compounds give a white precipitate when their aqueous solution are mixed? Now, please, students, I want 100% marks in this, 100% result. Can you show it? Please don't put mark the wrong answer. Which two compounds will give white precipitate when their aqueous solution are mixed? Silver nitrate, sodium chloride, silver nitrate, sodium iodide, sodium hydroxide, copper sulfate, sodium hydroxide, iron 2 chloride. Yes. So, fine. Please answer it fast. We have four more questions. Okay, fine. Last 20 seconds. This time I think I'm expecting 70, no, 80% result. Let's see how much it is. Everyone has voted, very good students. So now the answer of this question is A. Oh my God. Why students, more than 50, I've not got 50% only. Why? Question was not that tough. Question was very easy, see. Answer is A only. So many times we have discussed this type of question. Silver nitrate, silver chloride. Okay, you know, this is a very easy, very good question also to understand all type of neutralization reaction. What I can write? AgNO3 plus NaCl. Double displacement will happen. Ag will go with Cl, Na will go with NaNO3. Na will go with NO3. So you will get NaNO3 plus AgCl. AgCl is white in color. Now I will not write each and every reaction, I'll just write the product. Here silver nitrate, it is Ag plus NO3 minus. And sodium iodide Na plus I minus. So product is AgI. AgI is yellow in color. So this is not the answer. Sodium hydroxide Na plus OH minus. Copper plus 2, sulfate SO4 2 minus. Product is copper hydroxide. My dear student, what is color of copper hydroxide? You tell me. I am not going to tell you. What is the copper hydroxide? It is bluish color. Very good. It is blue in color. Okay, so why will reaction occur? Reaction occur because you can see it is, see, double displacement reaction. This is known as precipitation reaction. Precipitation reactions are always favorable. Okay, if you remember, I told you the Le Chatelier principle, if anyone remember. Do you remember Le Chatelier principle? How many of you remember Le Chatelier principle? Okay, fine, forget about that. Always remember the precipitation reactions are always favorable. Always favorable, whenever precipitate forms. So NaOH is here, CuSO4 is here. So the precipitate form is CuOH whole twice. This is the precipitate. That's why this reaction goes in forward direction. And you will get the, you will get Na2SO4. Le Chatelier principle. Sir, could you briefly tell aqueous solution that are white? That are white. Generally, zinc salts are white, calcium salts are white, calcium salts, zinc salts, okay, and aluminium salts are white, and what else? So, generally, Pb salts are also white, Pb plus 2 salts are white. These, okay, all group 1 atom salts are white, all group 1 atom. सोडियम हलीना की रक्त से फरियाद सोडियम पोटेशियम सीजियम जनरली दीज सॉल्ट्स आर वाइट ओके एनएसीएल सो जनरली दीज सॉल्ट्स आर वाइट इवन ग्रुप टू सॉल्ट्स आर ऑल्सो वाइट मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड वाइट ग्रुप वन ग्रुप टू दिस इज ग्रुप वन दिस इज ग्रुप टू दीज सॉल्ट्स आर वाइट इन कलर ओके एंड ऑल दोज इन द ग्रुप टू एज वेल These salts are generally white. Did you understand this? Can I move to next question? Thank you, students. Next question is this. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Today, I think who is leading will get to know at the end of the this thing only. I think Surya is still leading. Okay, no, Prishim, very good Prishim. Fine, moving to the next question. Okay, listen, please read the question carefully, okay? The tests are carried out to identify the aqueous solution of X. Aqueous sodium hydroxide is added and blue precipitate is produced. Dilute nitric acid is added, followed by aqueous silver nitrate and white precipitate is produced. Please write the answer. Please don't make mistake, my dear students. Please don't make mistake. Okay, how many of you have answered? Put Y. How many of you have answered? Put Y. Is it easy, tough, or what? Easy? Or tough or medium? 11th question again, definitely I'll show Meghna. Meghna, could I show it at the end of the, after 15th question, after 15th question, could I show? Could you wait for, fine. Please wait for 2 minutes, I'll show it after finishing this. Because we don't have much time now. Okay. Okay, so 55 have answered. Please answer it fast. You know, question is very easy. One is giving you the blue precipitate with sodium hydroxide. And one is giving you the, okay, everyone has voted. And answer is, okay, B is the answer. So answer is copper salts are blue in color. White was the silver, Cl. So answer was the salt which having a chloride ion. Any doubt in this question? Any doubt in this? Do you want me to show the question? No doubts? Good. Show the question. Ananya is saying, Ananya, it is very easy one. I'll show it in 1 minute. So see, the question is, okay. Question is like, which is the dilute salt? So I told you when you are white precipitate, that is Cl. So chloride is there because AgCl will form. That is a white color precipitate. So that is AgCl will form. AgCl. Okay, that is white precipitate. And blue color precipitate means copper plus 2 salts are there. So answer will be copper chloride. Answer is B. Copper chloride is the answer. Ananya, did you get this? Ananya? Okay. Moving to the next question. Okay, fine. So it says that this time Surya is again, I think he will lead fastest. Very good, Surya. Moving to the next one, we have. Okay, which gas relights a glowing splint? You have 17 more seconds. Which gas relights the glowing splint? Which gas relights? 10 more seconds. Fast, fast, fast. Okay, answer is nothing but oxygen. Oxygen is the answer. Very good. Next question. Okay, which statement about aqueous sodium hydroxide is correct? Please read it and answer it fast. Which statement about aqueous sodium hydroxide is correct? Okay. Which statement about aqueous sodium hydroxide is correct? When it is added to a solution containing sulfate ion, a white precipitate is formed. When it is added to a solution of copper 2 plus ion, okay, fine. Tell me what is the answer of this. Okay, 20 more seconds, students, you have. Please do it fast. Okay, 23 of you have answered it wrong, answer it correctly. So question was very easy. They have asked you what is the NaOH property, which of the following is having the, you have to tell about the NaOH, okay. So if you read the question, just a minute students, a solution sodium hydroxide, which is the added to a solution, sulfate ion, white precipitate, when it added to a sulfate ion, it gives white precipitate, no, it's not necessary. Which is added to the copper 2 plus ion, when it is added to a copper plus 2 ion. So blue precipitate is formed, which dissolves in aqueous deep blue solution. Yes, this is, but still it is not correct. It dissolves in ammonia. I told you copper 2 plus get dissolved in ammonia, but not in aqueous NaOH. Not in aqueous NaOH, no. But this is the correct answer. When added to this green precipitate, FeOH whole twice will form. Green color precipitate. Which does not dissolve in excess? Yes, it does not dissolve. This answer is correct. Which all dissolved in excess of NaOH? If you remember, I told you Pb, Zn and Al. These dissolved in aqueous, in excess NaOH also. And the last one, it is added to ammonium chloride, gas is produced, blue litmus red? No. Answer is C. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Then we are going to move to the last question. Yes, it is insoluble. All hydroxides of D block elements are insoluble. Except very few hydroxides, let's say group 1, other than group 1 hydroxide and NH4+, all are insoluble. Or sparingly soluble, yes. Understood? Understood, Sneha? Okay, what? That is sparingly, huh? Sparingly or weak, both are fine. Insoluble, we say sparingly soluble also. Okay, last question. Okay, just see the last question. Very easy question. Ammonium, aqueous sodium hydroxide is added to solid X and mixture is heated. The green precipitate form and alkaline gas is given off. Which of the following is present in X? Please answer it fast. Okay, so you have to tell that which is gas is given, which ion is present in the X. Green precipitate is forming and alkaline gas is given off. Green precipitate and alkaline gas. Okay, 56 have answered. Please answer it fast. Okay, fine. So answer of this question is ammonia gas and green color is Fe plus 2. So many times I told you green color is because of Fe2 plus salts. Fe3 plus salts are generally reddish brown. Fe3 plus reddish brown, Fe2 plus green color. And second thing is you had the basic gas that is nothing but ammonia. Ammonia gas is basic in nature. You know ammonia is a base. Let's see what is the leaderboard. Those who have doubt, please ask. Those who have doubt, please ask. I'll show the question. Ananya, I will show the question. Okay. Oh, very good, Surya. Congratulations, Surya. Very good. Okay, good. So those who want to leave, please leave. If those who want to see the question number 15, please see. Then we will discuss the other one also. Congrats, Surya. Very good. Those who want to leave, they can leave now. And I'm showing the question number 15. If anyone has doubt, please wait. Please wait for the question number 15 if you have doubt in there. Okay, so the question is, students, 1 minute. Yes, sodium hydroxide in solid X. You know, when you have the solid ammonium, see they have given the okay, students, 1 minute. I am sharing it again. Please give me a minute. Give me a minute. Please give me 1 minute. Okay. Okay, fine. So answer for this question is okay. Please see this. Okay. Please don't. Please mute your. Okay, students, can you see this? NH4 plus and Fe2 plus because Fe2 plus are green in color. So if you aqueous sodium hydroxide added in a solid X and heated, so any OH you have and let's say your X is having this green precipitate is forming. So this must be Fe plus 2 because it is going to form FeOH whole twice. This is green. Then, and an alkaline gas is given off. Definitely that will be having a
anion, a cation NH4 plus, because alkali gas is nothing but ammonia. So whenever you remember one thing I told you in last class, ammonium salts with alkali always give on heating, always give you ammonia gas. This I told in last class. Why is there any other basic gas? No. Ammonium salts, okay, whenever you add alkali, okay, whenever you add alkali, that will give you the.
Okay, see this. Whenever you have the alkali and ammonium salt, that will give you ammonia. In other, there is no other option. OH minus is not fitting at the best. Best option is NH4 plus only. Understood? You have to see options also. Is there any other basic gas? No. Ammonia is a gas that is basic in nature. Okay. Then. Okay, no other gas. No other gas. Understood? Okay, fine. You want me to solve, show which question? Tell me, student, which question you want to see? Someone asked one question, 11th number. 11. Okay, please see the 11th one. Those who want to leave, please leave. If you have done with all the questions, you can leave.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, students. Meghna done? Okay, fine. So thank you, students. So we'll meet on next week with the next quiz. Thank you. Bye.